And then overall, unhappy and unengaged employees. All of those things happen at an organization level. These are not things that have kind of started from the team level, and they cannot necessarily be helped at the team level. But there is a level in which we create this type of human debt at the team level as well. And that's the bit that we can and should be working on. And these are those ones that you're looking at now. So impression management, which is something that Mindy mentioned earlier, and it's a really big topic. I'll get into it in a second, but it happens, and it is the, let's just put it in short and give you a really quick definition. It is the opposite of psychological safety, if you wish, the dark side of psychological safety. It's when we are at a team level in a bubble, afraid to speak up because we would be looking a certain negative way to our colleagues. Those were afraid of looking ignorant, were afraid of looking negative, were afraid of looking, essentially any time that we are fearing a loss of status, then we are impression managing and we are attempting to show ourselves in a better light. Those times are obviously really detrimental to the team, and we are amassing human debt. All the times that we feel tension in the team, but we don't speak up about it, we don't talk about it, we hope it will resolve itself, it doesn't. It might resolve itself, but it will still leave enough of a mark on the team's overall health and well-being. When we witness someone that's being treated unfairly, but we don't say anything about it, either to them or to the team leader or to the team in itself. So when we feel we are brushing big topics under the carpet, like I was mentioning earlier, D&I, all the big race conversations, all the big conversations around employee happiness and so on, those are big, big pieces. And we are not discussing them, in particular, not at the team level. I'll tell you in a second why not. And when we don't, when we should be and we don't, we create more human debt, as we do when we know we should have done things that we haven't, like a team relaunch or a team building exercise, but we canceled it. We didn't have time, right? We're too busy. We're too full of day-to-day tasks. We're operationally heavy. So we tend to cancel. If we do, we amass human debt. When we have failures and mistakes, which we've not learned from, we haven't discussed, we haven't really used to our advantage, that is contributing to it. Anytime that we deprioritize the human work in favor of delivery, and this is kind of the crux of what we're talking about today, we all work in environments where we are asked to do, or where we have to do, not asked necessarily, where we have to do an extreme number of things, right? We all juggle hundreds of tasks and tickets and needs and feel like we're always racing against the clock. Everyone's overworked, people are burnt out. That happens at the team level as well. And when it does, obviously we're focused, really focused on getting through the day, getting through the tickets and just moving along and making sure that as much as possible has been moved to the done column. That said, while there's a lot of delivery work, there's a lot of operational work that needs to happen, we cannot and should not leave the human work aside because it will always come to bite us. This is the crux of what we're talking about today. So other examples are when we've avoided one-on-ones that we should have done, we've avoided conversations between ourselves we should have done, when we haven't invested in an emotional bond with our teammates, or when we have no idea about how to become better in terms of understanding our emotions and we don't train our EQ. We have to remember that, so EQ stands for emotional quotient, I'm sure everyone here knows, but we come to the workplace, all of us professionals, with no knowledge of how to understand emotions, whether they are of our own or of our colleagues. We have no formal training in this, right? No one comes out of school with extreme knowledge of both Java and how to read the emotions of their colleagues, right? Most people are completely oblivious as to how they are feeling and how others are feeling. And most importantly, we go to workplaces where we have been told that's not necessary, that no one pays you to have the skill of understanding how you feel and how others feel, because you're in a workplace. You're not expected to feel, you're expected to work, you're expected to deliver theoretical skills, you're expected to deliver expertise that's hands-on. You're never really expected to have read the emotions of others. That's obviously not working for us, and it's not going to work going forward, because we do work in these situations now where understanding how others feel, it is absolutely the difference between making things work and failing. So it is now the time that soft skills or EQ and the ability to understand how we feel and others feel so that we can actually work together better is more important than ever. And ideally people would get proper training. And if there is no training, that masses that kind of contributes to the human debt. When we have no interest in having a healthy and happy team with no human work invested in it, like I said earlier, and then again, not treating the human work as delivery, ops, dev work important. And most importantly, and almost not most importantly, but most interestingly, is when we're blaming the organization. This actually contributes to human debt. So when we say, we're fine at our team level, but this place we work in, they don't really care about us. They don't give us the things we need. They don't, and it's all true, right? All of these things are happening. We do work in these places where the organization is to blame, but that doesn't mean we should use that as an excuse and not work on these topics on top that we could and should be working on.